And let's get right after it. What's happening in Washington deserves your attention. It may be as dangerous as the pandemic. My question is, how many red flags do we need? Homeland Security just put out a warning of more possible violence to come from violent anti-government extremists fueled by false narratives that could continue to mobilize to incite or commit violence. Now, that's what the GOP has to say about this threat. Why? The only response they've had to the threat is to keep Biden from getting ahead of Homeland Security to head up the attack against this problem. Why? My argument, and it is why I caution Democrats wanting a power-sharing deal with McConnell, that is like insisting on petting a starving snake. The big mouth is gone, but the Retrumplican chorus remains, echoing his animus and hungry for more chaos. Think about it. Not a word about the ton of terrorists who say they acted not just on behalf of Trump, but because Trump told them to act. No comment from the leadership. Why? Cruz, Hawley, the senators desperate to be outspoken, Mr. Green Eggs and Ham himself, yet so quiet on how wrong this was. Why? The rest of you supposed Republicans, why are you so quiet on Cruz and Hawley? If you listen to them, they say we're against violence, we're against extremism on both sides. But while the fight against racism to them is really just an excuse to riot, right? BLM, bad, Antifa, like Al-Qaeda. But the Oath Keepers, QAnon, the Proud Boys, you know, the groups that the FBI are looking at? Silence. Yesterday, they had a chance to separate the GOP from the idea of what savaged our Capitol. And they voted to not even follow their duty under the Constitution. They just want to let Trump and this contagion continue to spread. If they won't do anything to speak out against it or hold the motivator to account, they must want more of the same. Just listen to their twisted thinking.
A trial of a former president is simply vindictive.
It's vindictive, it's backward-looking, it's unserious. It's constitutionally sketchy.
They hate Donald J. Trump, and they're engaging in an act that I think is petty. I think it is retribution. I think it is vindictive, and I think it's a waste of time.
You think vindictive was a talking point for them? You know what's vindictive, meaning seeking revenge? A coup. You know what's vindictive? A Confederate flag paraded through our Capitol that you say nothing about. You know what's vindictive? People forcing you to hide. You, Cruz. You hid in fear. You should have hid. We get it. Because they were looking for you. That's vindictive. By definition, seeking revenge. You know what that is? Inciting domestic terror. To attack the Capitol because you lost. That is vindictive. If you're going to have a talking point, apply it to the right things. This is vindictive. They wanted it to be vindication, but it wasn't, because democracy held. This is the same party that held Benghazi hearings for years, who now think we have to forget all about this attack on our Capitol. They just move on. Why? Well, people died in Benghazi. Remember that? People died. Yeah, yeah. One fewer than died in the Capitol. Why doesn't it matter? If they were not hell-bent on taking us all to hell in a handbasket, why would Mitch McConnell go from Trump provoked this and fed that mob lies, remember he said that, and pleading, we need time, let me move this trial, it must get due consideration, the president must have time to prepare. Why would he say that and then immediately go to voting to dismiss the trial before it even starts? He wants the chaos. They want to comfort our attackers by doing so. Again, just think about a better reason. Why would House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy go to Florida tomorrow to kiss the ring of the rogue former president? Why? There's only one reason. To stay close to the man who is the king of the chaos and the crazies. Matt Gaetz, a Florida nobody going to Wyoming tomorrow to smear a top Republican who spoke up against the king. The trip is a hit job on Liz Cheney. That's all it is. Why? She voted to impeach Trump. No one speaks against this guy. No one. Why? Think about it. They removed Steve King from committees. Remember him? Need more white babies? They did it reluctantly, but they did it after we kept highlighting his poison. But guess what they're doing now? They are empowering someone way worse. A QAnon kook, Marjorie Taylor Greene. This woman indicated support for executing prominent Democrats. She once called the Parkland shooting a false flag operation. Now she's been assigned to the House Education Committee. Look at this for an education.
David, why are you supporting the red flag laws? You are using your lobby and the money behind it and the kids to try to take away my Second Amendment rights. You don't have anything to say for yourself? If school zones were protected by with security guards with guns, there would be no mass shootings at schools.
Let me ask you something. Would you chase after a kid who survived a mass shooting, asking him why he doesn't want more guns? Seriously, think about it. I don't care how Second Amendment you are. I'm a gun owner, too. Would you do that? Bragging that you are doing it with a weapon on you as you antagonize this kid? And who's doing it? That woman thinks putting bullets in Nancy Pelosi is something to play with. And she wonders why anyone would question people like her getting a concealed carry permit. You are the reason for red flag laws, lady. This is the person that you promote? My Republican brothers and sisters? The party of Lincoln? Hello? You're promoting someone who's more like John Wilkes Booth than Lincoln. Don't you see? My fear is you do, and you like what you see. And for the rest of you, remember where their head is. Trump didn't get us here alone. Think about those who remain, who've sent every signal that they want to be every bit of his animus and more. Silent about the insurrection, slowing Homeland Security's ability to fight the same people that did this, silencing any who fight for the old GOP, promoting people who play at killing Nancy Pelosi, and members of the FBI. These who want to bring weapons into Congress but don't want metal detectors, subverting the Constitution to clear Trump, slow-walking pandemic response. Who does all of these things unless you want chaos? GOP used to stand for Grand Old Party. Now it's like Gang of Pirates. Let's bring in two wise men with some deadly serious advice. Van Jones, Michael Smirkanish. First, Smirk, am I off? I mean, what is the sum total of the calculus of their actions if they don't want more trouble?
You're off a little bit. I don't know that they necessarily want chaos. By the way, the Congresswoman, she's loathsome. So
they just
don't misunderstand what I'm about to tell
they
you.
They just promoted her.
Unbelievable. I mean, it's
so
right.
Why? They don't want worse, but they put someone who wants to kill Pelosi on a committee? How do you square those with not wanting chaos?
No, what I'm saying is that this is horrible to say, good for their business. Because, Chris, you got to get out of that bubble a little bit. The state legislatures, the gubernatorial mansions, the gain of seats in Congress, the probability that they will control the House if historical precedents hold firm. Add now in the data from Politico and Morning Consult today that says 56% of Republicans, they want Donald Trump to run again in 2024.
Yeah.
So the things that you and I and Van are discussing that we find horrible are actually ratifying that base, and that's their bread and butter.
All right, one quick thing, okay? I understand what you're saying. And we both do stories, shows on Sirius Radio. We get people from all over the country. I've been all over this country more than most people on this network, and certainly you have when it comes to reporting. I know Trump people. I live in a Trump county. I get it. What I'm saying, how you play the game at the top, Michael, matters. And the fact that you think it may be beneficial doesn't make it okay. Your silence about insurrections, I know, but you're saying, hey, this is good for them. It takes you to the same place I am, brother. They want the chaos.
I'm saying you would have expected the party to pay a price already. You would have expected the party to pay a price in the congressional elections.
I'm saying the price is yet to come. People are receptive to the animus. They are afraid. They're afraid of culture change. They're being baited that diversity is your downfall. I know it works. That's why demagogue is a Greek word, and there was never a positive opposite, Michael. It's effective. I'm saying it's now their plan. Now, Van, let me bounce to you. You guys want to work with them. You want a power-sharing deal. I mean, it's lunacy to me. You see what they're about. It is the wasp and the bullfrog. The wasp comes with one broken wing, gets on the back of the bullfrog, says, give me a ride across. The frog says, no, you're going to sting me. He says, no, why would I? We'll both die. Stings him right in the middle of the pond. On the way down, what does the wasp say? I am who I am. You know who they are. Why give them a ride?
Well, you're reducing the entire Republican Party to its worst elements. And I think that there are people who are wise who want to resist that. We are in a hell of a situation because we're damned if we do, we're damned if we don't. If we don't reach out and try to work with the Republicans, they say, well, look, these guys are out to get us. They won't work with us at all. They're going to run us over. We got to stick together. If we do reach out, then to your point, some will use that against us. I am a follower of Joe Biden at this point. I'm a Joe Biden Democrat. The only way to solve the actual problems is to get enough Republicans on board that we can get stuff done. And until all options have been exhausted, I think it makes sense for Democrats to reach out.